Imperialism consolidated the mixture of cultures and identities on a world scale. But its worst and most paradoxical gift was to allow people to believe that they were only, mainly, exclusively, white, or black, or Western, or Oriental. Yet just as human beings make their own history, they also make their cultures and ethnic identities. No one can deny the persisting continuities of long traditions, sustained habitations, national languages, and cultural geographies. But there seems no reason except fear and prejudice to keep insisting on their separation and distinctiveness, as if that was all human life was about. Survival, in fact, is about the connections between things. In Eliot's phrase, reality cannot be deprived of the other echoes that inhabit the garden. It is more rewarding and more difficult to think concretely and sympathetically about others than only about us. But this also means not trying to rule others, not trying to classify them or put them in hierarchies. Above all, not constantly to reiterate how our culture or country is number one or not number one for that matter. For the intellectual, there's quite enough of value to do without that.